Right, up next, Breeders is a Sky original comedy. It airs on Thursdays at 10, and it depicts the challenges of parenting, warts and all. Before I talk to its stars, Martin Freeman and Daisy Haggard, here's a clip.
There's all that amazing music and drama at Park Grove, the stencil art, the poetry slam.
I love poetry. I love it. The idea of it. But what about reading and maths? West Street is outstanding at reading and maths.
Am I going to a new school?
No.
Maybe. Not yet. Don't worry about it.
Let's not pressure them. It's only primary school. They should be enjoying themselves.
Yeah, I know, but if they don't pass their SATs, right, they don't get into the good secondary. Then they don't get into the good university, so they can't get a decent job, they can't afford to rent, let alone buy a flat, they can't settle down, they can't have kids.
Ava is only four. How have we got to her having kids already? Luke is happy where he is. Plus, it's 13 seconds away. It would take longer to teleport because you'd have to plug the teleporter in or connect it to Bluetooth or however they work. But what has brought this on?
Nothing's brought this on. I just...
Shut the fuck up! We're dispatching! Jesus Christ!
I just want what's best for the kids.
Hey! And Martin Freeman and Daisy Haggard join me now. Hi, guys.
Hi. Hello.
Are you going out later, Martin?
Maybe this is for you.
Thank you for making the effort.
Daisy? I'm never going to come on your show and not dress up.
Oh, that's very kind of you. Have you been in that outfit for about 2 weeks, Daisy?
I basically have. I did wash it for you, though, so I smell lovely, just so you know.
That's very kind of you.
I'm already regretting it. I'm really hot.
Okay. You can take the mouth off if you want. There you go. Oh, there you go. Oh, hair model zone. Oh, work it. Now, I've been really enjoying Breeders, but I was kind of surprised by it because I thought it was going to be a kind of cuddly family comedy, and it's not that, is it?
No, it's really not that. I think we thought there was just room in the world for a comedy that was still a comedy, but was quite sort of dark and quite unflinching, I suppose, about the harder parts of being not only a parent but being in a family situation, so as you were all your sort of close relationship.
But the language in the show, I mean, is really, you know, even for an old lag like me, kind of think that's quite strong. How did you manage to film, because obviously they are real children and apparently you're not supposed to swear in front of them?
Apparently you're not. There are quite strict guidelines as far as swearing in front of children is concerned, as there should be, obviously, just not in
of course.
But yeah, at work there should be. And so there would be different script sides. So if me and Daisy have a scene together, with the kids, all the swear words will be replaced by something a bit more mild so that the kids will never read scripts with bad words in. And so we'll do the kind of mild version in front of the kids. And then when the kids have done their coverage, they will go off with little headphones on into an adjacent room and me and Daisy will say all the sweary lines as written.
Apparently, Daisy, you struggled with some of the alternatives.
Yes, because they turned the script into something so surreal that I got completely giggly and could barely do it. So, like, rather than cock ring, it was clock ring. I don't know why that got me so much. I couldn't do that. Then it was fudge and sit. You can work these all out yourself. I don't know.
Well, also, presumably the children knew what you were supposed to be saying.
Actually, it was quite surreal, wasn't it, Martin? I don't know.
Yes, it was, yeah. I think sometimes, of course, they knew it's a sweary show. They know that there was very grown-up words in it. And I think that they sort of delighted in being able to be, you know, occasionally we would let one, you know, I happen to swear, Daisy swears quite a lot, I swear a lot, and occasionally we do, you know, the children definitely did hear some swear words, but their mums were very forgiving of us.
And weirdly, of course, this show, Breeders, it's taken on a kind of different resonance now, because so many people are stuck at home with their kids.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, in what is quite an unnatural way. You know, like, even people who love each other aren't used to being this close with each other all the time. So it's quite an interesting time. I mean, my kids are in a different stage to Daisy's. I mean, mine can be less hands-on. You know, they're doing their own thing at the moment, whereas Daisy's need attention a bit more.
Yeah, mine are 2 and 5, and it's just this terrifying thing as they get more and more bored and they look around the house and they're seeing it as some sort of terrifying playground where you're just going, you cannot hurt yourself. We are not going to hospital. Please be safe.
Well, you say that, Daisy, but then I think on day one of homeschooling, you built them this.
Oh, no. Like,
That does not look safe.
That is my husband's invention, and I can't bear it. But we put the teddies on it. But it's so frightening. I know. I took a photo of it. His invention. It's all his fault. But they are fine.
What's going on in this one? Because why are they staring at the pot plant?
A spider died. We found a dead spider, and I thought, that's half an hour. That is half an hour. I've got to bleach the fridge. That's amazing. So I was like, this is a really big deal, guys. And then I was like, I'm trying to teach them not to be scared of bugs, because I don't want girls that are like, ooh, about bugs. So I was like, this is an amazing spider. Then they got really upset, and I had to sort of backtrack a bit, because they were like, oh my gosh, the spider. So then they like FaceTime their aunt and uncle to talk about this terrible tragedy. But anyway, we did a funeral. It was useful. It was half an hour, and I bleached the fridge.
And for fear that anyone thinks you're not actually educating your children, you are doing real lessons. You posted this one. This was which daughter was this?
Oh my gosh, yes, that's Elsie. She's five.
What was the lesson?
It was writing a sentence, and a funny sentence. What is it? The pig likes to fart, isn't it?
Well, it's the pig licks to fart.
Oh, licks to fart, yeah. That's right. Well, it does, Graham.
Daisy, you know I'm a huge fan of Back to Life, and I believe Back to Life is still, that's all up on iPlayer right now, right?
It is, yes, it is.
Have you filmed series two? Is that in the can now?
No, I am trying to write that now as well, in these circumstances, so that's fun. They sit on my lap and they tend to take over my script and write lots of things that I have to delete afterwards, like just stuff like that.
Or the pig licks the fart. It's quite a good line.
I mean, that's probably going to go in. That's gold.
Well, look, thanks for joining me. Stay safe, stay sane. Breeders continues on Sky One. It's also available on Sky On Demand and the streaming service Now TV. Martin and Daisy, bye-bye.
Thanks, Graham.
Now, Daisy isn't the only...